The murderer didn't need it. Let's just take another penalty. Why would the murderer have spent the time looking for the stray bullet? I haven't got a clue. What's wrong, Mr. Wright? The murderer had no reason to take that bullet. You don't want to admit it, but it's true. Had to take it. Had to take it? The murderer? What does that mean? You're thinking too normal. Think crazy! Woo! Don't think why the bullet was taken. Think why the bullet had to be taken.
Mr. Wright!
Unless Von Karma was outside the elevator when the gun went off. And it went into Von Karma, and that would explain why he took such a long vacation.
The murderer had no intention of taking the bullet from the scene. But the murderer has to take that bullet.
Had to, Mr. Wright, what do you mean?
Well, for instance... for instance what? Maybe the bullet hit the murderer.
The bullet hit the murderer?
Just saying, for instance. I mean, if it hit you, you would have to take it with you, wouldn't you? It's not like you could perform surgery right there. You know?
The first bullet went into... Well, one of the bullets went into Gregory. The other bullet must have gone outside the elevator and hit into someone. Probably Von Karma.
I was just talking off the top of my head, but what if that's really what happened?
Let me get this straight. So at the time of the murderer himself was shot, and he left with the second bullet still inside? Does he have only one bullet to the scene of the crime?
Yes, I guess that's how it would work, yes.
But there's a problem with that. The other two people rescued from that elevator, Miles Edgeworth and Yanni Yogi, were both unarmed. So that would mean...
The murder came from outside, yes.
But how could it have used that gun? I disagree. I have all kinds of disagreement.
The two men fight inside the elevator. Trying to stop them, the boy picks up the pistol at his feet and throws it. The pistol discharges, and the bullet. The bullet goes through the elevator door and hits the murderer outside. The boy loses consciousness. And then they open the door.
Okay.
I'm guessing this is Von Karma then. Because it was Von Karma and Yanni working together in this case. And that would explain... Because he's got a bullet hole... Because he's got a bullet wound. That would explain the long the long vacation that he took. The long completely... like, unexpected vacation.
Mr. Wright, you're truly the most unpredictable defense attorney I've ever known. I can say you're grasping, yet I cannot deny the possibility of what you say.
And that would also explain why... why Von Karma went on to take Miles as his kind of protege. Because he felt an obligation as his father's murderer. I don't really know. Let's see.
What are you saying? Deny it! Deny it! No one involved with the incident was wounded. There was no murderer.
No one was wounded at the time of the incident.
He's right. I can't think of anyone.
Hey, Nick.
Huh?
I just thought of something really crazy.
Crazy?
Remember what Mr. Grossberg said yesterday?
I remember a lot of it.
Gregory Andrews dealt a blow to his perfect trial record.
Wow.
It must have been quite a shock for Von Karma. He took a vacation for several months after that, you see. An unusual event for the man. That was the first and the last vacation he's had taken in his many years of prosecuting.
That explains it. What if Von Karma didn't take that vacation because of shock?
But take it because he was injured.
Which would mean...
It could only be one thing.
He was the murderer in the DL6 incident.
He was the man who shot Gregory Edgeworth.
It was Von Karma.
Oh, man.
Something wrong with Wright, you seem dazed.
No, Your Honor.
Well, you have indicated the possibility that the murderer came from outside. Can you give us the name of your suspect?
Da-da-da. Should we come out and say it now?
Yep,
why not?
No time like the present.
Your Honor, there is a suspect, one lone suspect. Ellipses.
Well, this is certainly interesting news. Very well, Mr. Wright. Who is your suspect?
My hands are shaking.
What?
Von Karma!
Von Karma.
He looks happy. Ellipses everywhere. Ellipses in your hair.
You mean the Von Karma, the prosecutor? Sitting right there? Bah. You don't object? Humph. I see no need. Why on this ridiculous outburst with my objection? Because you took a vacation for several months, starting the day after the incident. Yet you pride yourself on a perfect record. Why would you take such a long vacation without any reason? So claim that I took a vacation to heal my injury from the innocent, from the incident. Fascinating. Prove it. I would have needed surgery, no? Where'd I go under the knife at, Mr. Wright? Bring the doctor to operate on me. Have him testify.
Nick! Let's find out who his doctor is.
It's no use. I know Von Karma. Perhaps too well. He's perfect. He wouldn't leave clues. He probably didn't undergo surgery. That would leave a doctor as a witness. He just bore with the pain and took it like a man.
So what now, Nick? Did Von Karma pull out the bullet by himself? That's insane!
No, he couldn't have. You can't just pull bullets out of yourself.
So the bullet's still inside him.
Wait. What does that mean? That bullet has to be somewhere. But where? Tisk. Well, Mr. Wright. Can you produce evidence to prove that I was shot?
Yes.
We can.
We actually can.
All right, Von Karma, I'll prove it. And leave it use evidence. I know how you like it so much. What? The evidence that proves Von Karma was shot is...
We can prove it. We can do this.
Take that. Von Karma is perfect. He wouldn't risk surgery, leaving evidence trail. So then I ask, where is the bullet now? I think it's unlikely that Von Karma performed surgery on himself.
Ellipses.
You don't mean...
I do. There is a possibility that the bullet is still inside Von Karma.
Is that even possible for all these years?
Well, there's one way to find out. We could use a metal detector. Well, Von Karma, I'm going to run this over you and see what we find.
He's sweating.
I refuse!
You refuse? What refusing this means?
You acknowledge the bullet is still inside you?
Hey, if you're innocent, you got nothing to hide.
Order!
Your Honor, the defense requests that we be allowed to use a metal detector. Judge, I call for suspension of this trial. This is an invasion of privacy. Statute of limitations runs out on this case today. It was you who said we had to end it right here, right now, right here, right now, right here.
God, stop it.
Enough! I permit the use of the metal detector. Mr. Von Karma, you will submit yourself to testing.
Amazing.
I don't know, but we have to give it a shot.
That's a good sign.
It reacted, something to his right shoulder. The bullet. Mr. Von Karma.
Ellipses.
You. It was you.
Ellipses.
I was afraid this would happen, and so I remained silent. Indeed, there is a bullet in my right shoulder. However, it has nothing to do with this incident.
Oh dear God. That's a good point, actually. How are we going to prove this has anything to do with the trial? With the DL6 incident?
I was shot in the shoulder long before the DL6 incident. I claim the bullet in my shoulder has no relation to DL6.
Really now? Oh wait, what about the ballistics pattern? The ballistics markings?
Yes! But Mr. Von Karma, can you prove that? Prove? I have no obligation to prove anything. It is you who must prove something here, Mr. Wright. Not I.
Mr. Wright? Well, can you prove it? Can you prove that the bullet in Von Karma's shoulder was from DL6?
The ballistic mark... Oh, I guess it'll take too long to run a ballistic marking. To A, get the bullet out of his shoulder. And B, actually test them.
You don't have any of the DL6 evidence. That's because you took it out of the records room yesterday. With no proof, you cannot convict me of any crime. So sorry, Mr. Wright.
But I do have one piece of evidence. A bullet with similar ballistics markings.
I'm the one who's sorry, Mr. Von Karma. What? You were close. One day away from freedom. You see, I have proof. What? Who would have thought you would have dug your own grave trying to convict Edgeworth? I can link that bullet in your shoulder to the DL6 incident. And here's my final proof.
I'm guessing that it's going to be the style of bullet or the... Still bears clear ballistic markings. It's probably going to be the ballistic markings. Take that.
That's... a bullet? Where did you get that? This is the bullet used in the DL6 incident. This was taken from the heart of the victim, Mr. Gregory Edgeworth. The bullet is preserved quite nicely with all the ballistic markings intact. Ballistic markings.
Yes, ballistic markings.
You may recall the term. It came from the first trial 2 days ago. Ballistic markings are the fingerprints of a weapon. All bullets fired from a gun are marked with that weapon's unique pattern. By examining the markings, you can tell which weapon fired the bullet. It's quite accurate.
So if we've just got to, like, grab a knife and cut him open and get the bullet out.
We have two bullets in our possession. One, the bullet ruined Gregory Edgeworth's heart. The other, Mr. Von Karma, is the bullet buried in your shoulder. We can analyze both bullets. If the markings matched, we would know that both bullets have been fired from the same gun. The very same pistol. In other words, the murder weapon that killed Gregory Edgeworth. Why, I order. Mr. Von Karma, you will let us remove the bullet from your shoulder. Then we'll compare the ballistic markings to those on this bullet. And solve this case once and for all.
And I'm guessing that he's not going to let us. Oh no, there we go, he's doing his death cry.
That scream. I've heard that scream before. Wait, I know.
When he got shot?
Help, I can't breathe. Quiet, I say quiet. You're not making this any easier. Stop breathing my air. I'll stop you. Stop breathing my air. Get away. Get away from my father!
Bang.
That's the Von Karma cry.
It's his battle cry.
It's that scream I've heard in the elevator. 15 years ago. Von Karma! It was you who screamed! It was you! Mr. Von Karma? Edgeworth! Edgeworth! Only you would dare defy me! So was you.
Oh god. Bang. 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 Okay.
You and your father are my curse! Your father shamed me with a penalty on my record. And you. You left a scar on my shoulder that would never fade. I'll bury you! I'll bury you with my bare hands! Death! Death!
Okay, take it a bit. Calm down. Take a chill pill, please. Please, just. Calm. Calm. Okay. There we go. See, nice and calm. It's not that difficult.
Meanwhile, 15 years earlier. Mr. Chief Prosecutor, I'm sorry. Von Karma, it's not like you to make this kind of error.
I never would have thought that Edgeworth would be the one to catch you.
I was careless. I'm sorry, but you'll have to be penalised. I've covered you in the past, but not this time.
That's way smart.
Edgeworth! It was a shock like none I had ever known. Me, penalised. It took hours for me to regain my composure. Suddenly I found myself in the darkness. I was in the court records room. I must have wandered in there without thinking where I was going. The room was pitch black. The lights must have gone out. I went out in the hall and felt my way to the elevator. Pressed the button, nothing happened. Then there was a noise. I was in pain, a horrible burning pain in my shoulder. Just then the lights came back on, the elevator door opened before my eyes. And in the heat of the moment, I saw three people inside, all lying unconscious from oxygen deprivation. Much to my surprise, a pistol lay at my feet. I knew then it was destiny.
And so he decided to shoot a guy. Cool. I do that every time I just randomly wait, find a pistol by my feet.
In his last moments, Gregory Edgeworth was still unconscious. He died never knowing who had shot him. Later, he spoke through a medium blaming Mr. Yogi. He was fooled. It was the perfect crime.
So he was actually trying to cover for Edgeworth, I guess. Fair enough. So, Gregory Edgeworth died believing that his son had killed him. That's sad. That's feels worthy.
Tisk, tisk, tisk. Who would have thought another man would have come to open that elevator door? Judge! What? What are you doing? Do your job. Bring an end to this miserable charade. Now end it.
Very well.
And that's going to be the end of the court trial.
It appears to go a very long way to the end of this maze. 15 years later, Mr. Miles Edgeworth.
Yes, Your Honor.
You're innocent. You're innocent. As you said, it was all a nightmare.
Yes, Your Honor.
This court finds the defendant, Mr. Miles Edgeworth,
not guilty. And underneath it should come up with again. Well, you know, two not guilties and a guilty means not guilty.
That is all, the court's adjourned.
December 28th, 5:38 PM. My God, it's 5:38 PM. God, we're working overtime today. District Court Defendant Lobby Number 2.
Nick, we did it! Did you see his face? Von Karma looks even paler than usual. You pretended to be all cool, but inside you crushed him, Nick. Crushed! I gotta say, I'm impressed.
Heh, it was pretty close, though. I was sure we'd had it.
I know, I was on the verge of tears the whole time, myself. But now it's all just a good memory.
Ellipses. So it's finally over, Edgeworth. Ellipses. Right.
Yeah.
Ellipses. I'm not trying to say this.
I know. Try thank you.
I see. Ellipses. Thank you, right.
You're welcome. And then they hugged and everything was better all over again. And Edgeworth Wright was still the true OTP of the year every year.
I think you're better than that.
Sorry, I'm not good at this sort of thing.
You got a lot to learn, Edgeworth.
Dear, dear.
Whoop! Amazing, pal. You pulled through just like I thought you would. I'll never forget this. I owe one, pal. And so, let's party. Dinner's on me. Yeah, my salary went down a bit this month. But who cares?
See, Mr. Edgeworth? You should take a lesson from Detective Gumshoe. That's how you say thank you.
I see. Whoop! How was that? I feel foolish.
Don't worry, take it a little at a time. You'll get used to it.
It's been 15 years since I've seen Edgeworth this unguarded.
Hey, y'all!
Oh god, it's her.
Lada! Y'all were great in there!
Thank you.
Yo, Edgeworth, congrats!
Thank y'all very much.
And you're innocent from the start, of course. Just look at you. You wouldn't stick your hand in the cookie jar even if no one was there.
You were the witness on the first day of trial, weren't you?
Yeah, well, let bygones be bygones, eh?
Why is she doing here? What is she doing here, actually?
I'm not sure. Speaking of which, what are you doing now, Lotto?
Who, me? Oh, I'm back to college. I gave up trying to be an investigative photographer pretty quick.
Really? That's too bad.
Huh?
It's all our fault that she stopped being a investigative photographer.
Isn't that the hot dog guy from the park?
Huh?
It's Larry! It's over, Nick. My life is over.
Why the sad face, Larry? What happened now?
Oh, Nick, I'm not long for this world.
You don't look sick.
It's Kianse. She's going to live in Paris. Paris, Nick. She's leaving me behind.
Larry.
Yo, Edgy, there you are.
And suddenly he's happy again. Yes, here I am.
Congrats, Edgy. Here, a little gift for me in celebration.
Celebration? That's unusual for you. Harry Butts, you come along tonight too. March Street, pal.
Thanks. Looking forward to it.
Yo, Nick. That's the suit that questioned me.
When he says treats, that's not police talk for prison food, right?
Yeah, I'm sure it is. I think it'd be fine, Larry.
Right.
Yeah, what's up?
That envelope that Larry gave me. It's got money in it.
Well, yeah, that's not that strange. People give money away to celebrate sometimes.
It's $38, right?
Was it Larry the whole time?
If something smells, it is usually the butts. What a weird amount. I mean, it's not a little, but it's not a lot either.
$38 exactly.
Nick! Wasn't that exactly the amount of lunch money that was stolen from Mr. Edgeworth in school?
$38. No!
No! Larry, it was you!
What are you so surprised about, right?
Huh?
Larry was absent that day from school, right? That does not automatically rule him out as a suspect. Think back to that day 15 years ago. Larry took the day off, but he was bored. He came into school anyway. Then he saw the money lying there, and the rest is history.
And everyone's good at history.
Edgeworth, you didn't know, did you? I suspected. I just couldn't picture Larry protecting you like he did that day. Everyone else was saying you did it. The whole class was against you, remember? Yeah, too well. Right, you may not know this, but we used to have a saying back in school. When something smells, it's usually the butt. I know, I know. Really, right, I'm surprised you didn't figure it out.
Oh, Edgeworth.
You should have told me.
No, no, Nick, it was 15 years ago. Don't you think the statute of limitations have run out, Mr. Edgeworth?
I'd say so, yes.
There you have it.
Grr.
Where does that leave me? I'm becoming a defense attorney because of what you two did.
Well, I'd call you a goody two-shoes to the extreme.
Yeah, and you get worked up too easily, too. Death! The death sentence for both of you. Man, if only I'd known, I'd become a prosecutor.
The same goes for me, only the other way around. For the longest time, I thought I meant to kill my own father. I thought...
Yeah, I think his story's a little bit more, a little bit more... emotional, shall we say?
I thought I'd become a criminal. I became a prosecutor in part to punish myself. If I had known the truth, I might have become a defense attorney, after all. Edgeworth. Want to switch right?
Hey, y'all! Line up, I'll take a photo! Hey, photo time, let's go!
And after that, dinner on me!
He's really pushing this dinner on him stuff. I'd be surprised if he could afford it, to be honest.
Detective Gumshoe took us out on the town that night. We celebrated Edgeworth's newfound freedom. Although, Edgeworth was still in detention.
December 29th, 5:02 a.m. 5:02 a.m.? Jeez. Right in court, law officers.
Have we just got home or something?
Whoa, I went a little overboard yesterday.
My head hurts.
Huh?
It's still only 5? Maybe I should go back to sleep.
Huh?
What's this? A letter?
Good morning, Nick. You were really impressive yesterday. Seeing you, it made me think about what I'm doing here. I'm a spirit medium, in training, of course. I want to tell Mr. Edgeworth, too. I want to tell you, but I couldn't. I was useless. So I decided to go back to my training. I'll become a full-fledged spirit medium for starters. I couldn't say it to your face, so I left this letter. Goodbye, Nick.
Goodbye?
What time is it? Ah! The first trains for the mountains have already left.
To the station!
Quick! To the station!
This is like the only time this background's even used in the game. Ellipses.
I guess I'm too late.
Hey! Nick!
Maya!
Ellipses, ellipses, ellipses.
So, you're leaving?
Yeah, it's hard being a spirit medium and can't talk to spirits. And I think you'll do fine without me, Nick. Be good, okay?
Don't leave, Maya! I'm just imagining going,
hold it!
The bill was printed. Everyone's like crowded around and looks.
Did you just show hold it?
What?
Let's see. I never could have saved Edgeworth without you, without your help.
Huh?
On the last day of the trial, I heard her. I heard Mia's voice.
You heard my sister?
Yes, only her voice, but still. It was at the very end when I thought we'd just lost everything.
Well, that's my sister for you. Detective Gumshoe helped, and Mr. Grossberg, and
Even Larry. I'm the only one who couldn't help. I was useless, Nick. But you were the only one who stopped... But you were the one who stopped Von Karmermeyer. Huh? I didn't do anything. All I did was wander around in a daze.
Sorry, but I have evidence that you helped.
I do have evidence that you helped, because it was at the end of the last investigation section. It was the bullet. And now for the very last voice command of the case.
Take that!
And of course, it didn't work.
Take that!
Take that!
I should have figured that wouldn't work first time.
A bullet!
Von Karm was convinced he had taken all the evidence pertaining to DL6. But you were the one who rescued the last piece of evidence we needed. This was the bullet that put an end to Von Karma. And you were the one who gave it to me.
Nick!
Thanks, Maya. I couldn't have done it without you.
Yay! I'll be back soon. Oh, she's still going. That's not right. I'm going to complete my training and come back.
She's crying.
Okay, I'll be waiting.
Of course you will. You can't run that office by yourself. You're hopeless.
I don't know about that.
This is a very final thing. This is very much an ending. For reasons I'll explain in a minute. So, bye.
Bye.
Bye!
Bye.
No, you hang up. No, you hang up.
And Maya leaves. Thanks, Nick. Oh, Maya, she's gone.
And so my story ends. Time to turn a new page. And say goodbye to the novice defense attorney that I once was. Now a new story begins. With the same old crazy cast of characters.
Ha! Don't think you've graduated yet, amateur.
Mr. Wright, perhaps you'd like to rethink that claim?
What the hell?
I got a bad feeling about this.
I don't know what that was all about. Oh, now we get the credit sequence. Yeah, this is actually the ending. Originally...
Hey pal, Mr. Edgeworth came down to the precinct to wish me a happy new year. Talk about a pleasant surprise.
Oh my god.
Whoop!
Oh, that makes all the sense in the world. Originally, this was the end of the game. When this was originally released in Japan, it only consisted of 4 cases. When this was remade...
Nick, I haven't seen lately. Who, me? I've been working at a cheese shop.
A cheese shop?
That Missy's a nice lady, but she's not exactly what you call a cheap date.
He's dating Missy? From Doctor Who? Oh my god.
The plot thickens.
This was the original end of the game. On the Game Boy Advance version, which was only released in Japan. When it was released in the West on DS and remade, they added a 5th case, which is going to be somewhat different, but it is going to tie into a later game.
That's ring my own bell. It's not a thought of everything he knows. I'm sure he's grateful.
And now we're going to see everyone in the background. So essentially, this is the end of the main game. Essentially, next episode, we're going to be starting post-game. But the 5th case is actually bigger than all the other cases in this game.
Oh, the defense attorney forgot I wrote that affidavit for. Affidavit.
Affidavit sounds so weird. I know he's talking in the background, but like affidavit just sounds odd to me. I don't know. It just doesn't look like how that word's supposed to be pronounced. It's weird. As we are. Grossberg!
Oh, it's you! Phoenix Wright? Ah, yes, Mears understudy, was he not? I wonder how he's doing. Haven't seen him of late. Ah, the days of my youth. Like the scent of fresh lemon, you see.
Makes sense. And so... Yeah, the next case is actually the longest in the game. But it's... Because it was remade for the DS, it kind of... It's closer related to the... Apollo series, which is like the 4th game.
Nothing on TV is.
Yeah, when he's talking. It's closer related to the 4th game than the 1st game. But it does. It's still got Phoenix the main character. It doesn't have Maya. So we've got a new assistant. And I guess we'll, like, talk about it more in the actual episode. I sure that Mr. Wright a great deal. Oh, I'm keeping my face on public eye till the show's over. I won't want to ruin any kid's dreams, you know. Oh yeah, he's a pink princess now. Because that's appropriate. Go on, what are the characters, what are the wonderful, colourful characters we met throughout this game? Who else have we not seen? We're going through the Steel Samurai cast at the moment. Oh, I got a letter from Maya the other day. He says that she caught a cold standing under a waterfall.
Typical.
I wanted to visit, but didn't have time, so I sent her some Pink Princess trading cards. She says she can't buy them where she is. What kind of place are you living at, anyway? Well, she's a spirit medium in training. Man, this game's been awesome. this game generally is awesome. This game, I had a lot less problem. I got through the... Let's talk Pink Princess. I had a lot of less problem this time playing through the game than I did when I first played through the game. It's been kind of weird in my head, because I've had this... Every single case, I've had this kind of... sort of inkling that I know which direction it's going to go in, but at the same time, I just couldn't remember any of the specific details. And it's weird how talking aloud helps you kind of focus your train of thought. It's like, I think this game would be an easier one to LP than it is to play. And I'm not sure whether it was that factor coming into effect, or whether it was me genuinely remembering stuff. I don't really know. I still got a little bit confused around the end of the fourth case, but I think everything's, like, in order now. And everything, you know, the great thing about the Phoenix Wright games is that it just kind of makes sense. There's Mia! She's a ghost! Is that the picture that Lotta took? Because I'd be very scared if, like, Lotta took a picture and then there's a random ghost in it. Bye, Capcom! Except, that is not the end of the game! Yeah, that's the part that was added for the re-release. A brand new episode has been added. We shall go ahead and save clear data up to this point. However, we shall not be starting the last episode yet. Well, at least not in this recording session. So there we go. Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney has been completed. When we return next time on Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney... Postgame. Technically? Postgame. See you next time, folks. Physics! What are you doing? Physics. Come on now.